Welcome all. I am Shraddha Shaike. Today we will be talking about 4-bit shift register using D flip-flop. In this experiment, we have to use D flip-flop and we have to implement 4-bit shift register using that. So IC which we are going to use is IC 7474. This IC is a 4-bit. This IC is a IC of the D flip-flop. So inside this IC there are two D flip-flops present. So this is the pin diagram of IC. If we observe, the pin number 1 is for the reset terminal, which is the active low pin. It should be connected to the ground. Pin number 2 is the first input of the D flip-flop, which you can say flip-flop 1. Pin number 3 is the clock 1, or the clock input. Pin number 4 is a preset input. So preset input is also active low. In order to use this as a normal flip-flop, we will connect this to the VCC. Then you will observe pin number 5 is the Q1, which is the output. 6 is the Q1 bar, which is the complementary output. 7 is the ground, you can say. 14 is VCC. Now there is one more D flip-flop present over here. So pin number 13 is reset, which we are going to connect to the VCC. If you connect reset to the ground, then output Q of your flip-flop will be reset, that is 0, irrespective of the clock or the input. And if you connect preset to the ground, that means if you activate the preset, then output of the flip-flop will be 0 irrespective of the D. 12 is the D input of this second flip-flop. 11 is the clock input. Preset 2, as I told you, Q2 connected is at the 9 and Q2 bar is at the 8. Now what we will do, we are going to do, we have to construct a 4-bit shift register. As you know, a shift register is a sequential circuit, right? So we have to use 4 D flip-flops. Let us say D0, D1, D2, D3 as shown in this diagram. Then a shift register is a synchronous circuit because clock is common. So say same clock is applied to all the flip-flops. The first input D0 is to be connected to 1 or 0. Then if you observe, the output Q1 of the first flip-flop is connected to the input D1 of the next flip-flop. Output Q0 is connected to the input D1. Output Q1 is connected to the input D2. Output Q2 is connected to the input D3. So output of 1 is connected to the input of next flip-flop. 4 LEDs are to be connected at Q0, Q1, Q2 and Q3. Then reset inputs and preset inputs of all the flip-flops should be deactivated. So as we have studied in the pin diagram, resets are active low, so in order to deactivate that, we will be connecting it to the VCC. And this is the truth table of the flip-flop. So initially what will be happening, the output of all the flip-flops is 0, that is Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3, 0. And the input D0 is, if you connect it to 1, then for the first clock pulse, first rising clock pulse or falling clock pulse, it depends on the IC which you are using. So IC 7474 is a positive, or you can say rising clock pulse, it is going to respond. So if D1 is 1, you will observe the output Q0 is 1, Q1, Q2, Q3, 0, 0, 0. For the next clock pulse, Q0, Q1 is 1, 1, Q2 and Q3 is 0, 0, and so on. So if you observe, for the fifth clock pulse, all the outputs are 1. Data is still shifting, but all the outputs are 1, that's why we cannot observe. So in order to observe the data, we have to connect the D0 input to the logic 0. So let us observe. This is the connection diagram of our circuit. So I will switch off the power supply initially. So let me explain you. So I have used the two ICs because one IC consists of the two D flip-flops. Then VCC and ground is connected to both the ICs. As I told you, reset and preset, that is pin number 1, 4 and 13 and 10, right? this should be deactivated. So all are connected to VCC because they are active low. So this is to be done for both the ICs. Then four LEDs are connected, where LEDs are connected to pin number 5, then pin number 9. I am not interested to take Q1 bar and Q2 bar. I don't want to check the complementary output. So four LEDs are connected at the, you can say four LEDs are connected at pin number 5 and one at 5, one at 9, again one at 5 and other at 9. Right, then as you observe, the output of first flip-flop is connected to the input of next. So for that, output Q1, that is pin number 5, is connected to the next input, that is pin number 12. So it is connected over here. Q1 is connected to the 12 and so on. So, and for the next third flip-flop, the output, which is pin number 9 of the one IC, is connected to the pin number 2 of the next IC. Same clock is applied. Now this is my Q0, Q1, Q2 and Q3. So let me connect VCC and ground first. So I'll be connecting the ground first. Okay, the ground pin is connected now. If D is 0, so all the LEDs are off. You will observe initially, as per the truth table, all the LEDs are off. Now if I will connect D0 to 1, so only Q1 will become on, then Q0 will become on, Q0, Q1, Q0, Q1, Q2 and so on. So observe, this is how the data is shifting. If I will connect it to 0, off. I can reduce the frequency so that the speed will be reduced. Let me set frequency as 0.9 now. 0, 0, 0 and 0. So now data is still shifting, but all the bits are 0, that's why we cannot observe. So I will again connect this input to VCC, or you can see this is a floating, as I explain you, a floating is considered as logic 1 in case of TTL ICs. So either terminate it to logic 1 or keep it floating, it will be considered as 1 only, but you have to always terminate it. So this is how the data is shifting, 1, 1, 1, 1. We can also construct the ring counter by connecting the last output to the input of the first. For construction of the ring counter, what we can do? We can connect the last output to the input of the first whenever one LED is on. So this is the last output, that is Q9 pin should be connected to the first input when one LED is on. So you will observe the ring counter. Thank you.